just with me today.
What
made it easy?
Team. Karen Peisel, who's our project manager. She takes care of all of us and makes sure we're on duty. And then Brittany Conklin, she is our staff attorney. And then I want to introduce our founder and president and my good buddy, David Boone, who got me into this. So I'm glad he did.
We also have our director of field operations who drove up from Middle Georgia. One thing not about having glasses that automatically tint, they forget when you come inside. I want to take an opportunity first to thank each and every one of you for being here. The support that we've had for Cause is a 501c3, it's a charity, we're all volunteers. And we need more volunteers, we need your talent, your time, and of course we need your economic support. And we thank every one of you for being here. And what's great about this is that we get to keep meeting our friends over and over again as we develop the science. I want to take a moment and thank a couple special people for being here. First, I will tell you, I'm a civil lawyer. I've been a civil lawyer for almost 40 years. I know everybody's supposed to say, no, that can't possibly be. But I tell you, before I started this charity, my young daughter came back from India on a mission trip, and she came back with a story about sex trafficking and sex slavery in India. And I started to study it, and I learned that it's Reuters reports it is a $150 billion problem annually in the world. 70% of those dollars are thought to be US dollars. When I started reading about it, it is a $10 billion plus problem right here in the United States. That's the onshore. I always knew that there was offshore, fat cats would go offshore and do their nasty. I didn't realize that it was here onshore, and it is, and not only is it a problem, but it's a problem that's growing. So I actually phoned one of our special guests tonight, Sam Olens. Sam is the Attorney General, he's statewide elected, he is the Chief Law Enforcement Officer for the state of Georgia, and he's absolutely committed himself to exposing the horrors of this problem, and he's actually taken some affirmative steps, which George is not buying it, and he's taken some other things, but he also hired out of the Fulton District Attorney's Office a seasoned prosecutor, Camila Wright, and Camila's here with her husband, Shaw, and Sam and Camila have dedicated themselves to working on the human trafficking and commercial sexual exploitation of children primarily. And often I'll say women, and I apologize if I don't add to it, 15% of the victims are men, so we just have to kind of remember some of these people. But between Sam and Camila Wright, I have gone to them for guidance as to how CLAWSE, as a voluntary resource, can aid them in law enforcement. How can we be supportive of their victims? How can we be supportive of their research? How can we help them? Another friend of ours in the room, Chief Gary Yadura from the Brookhaven Police Department was here earlier. I'm not sure if he's still here, but he's absolutely a prince of a human being. And he's worked very hard in the new municipality of Brookhaven to ferret out some of the darkness. Another special person that I got the pleasure of meeting about a year ago is Senator Renee Unterman from Gwinnett County with the State Senate here in Georgia. And Senator Unterman has really, she was a nurse by training, she's become a state senator, and she's taken the lead in setting public policy by passing legislation to expose and outlaw this horrible cancer that we have in our society of commercial sexual exploitation of children. And I want to tell you that I look at things more of a scientific basis, and I really want to thank my alma mater, the University of Central Florida. They have an initiative on human trafficking, and they sent a group of their social scientists to be with us today. At University of Central Florida, we're trying to apply science to a very human social problem. But if we apply science to it first, then we ought to be able to deconstruct it and figure out some of the solutions, the social solutions. So from the University of Central Florida, UCF stands for opportunity, and we have a wonderful group. The director of the initiative program is a Pulitzer Prize winning journalist, John Garcia, and John is going to be here tonight. God bless him. He had a wife of many years, had some issues this morning, and so he had to cancel last minute. I want to also take a moment personally and thank my two Atlanta law partners, Simone Sykes and Bill Stone, who put up with me and with this initiative. They listened to my stories, they listened to the true facts of the horrors of commercial sex exploitation of women and children, and they've been very supportive of us, so I thank the two of them. I also want to thank my dear law partner, Michael Davis from Fort Lauderdale, and I'll tell you, I hired him in 1978 to join me in the law practice, and he's been with me by my side ever since. And he and his lovely wife, Marcella, came up to be part of this tonight, and I thank him for that. And I just am so blessed to be here. I want to thank Representative Tom Taylor for being with us tonight. He's led some of the legislative changes and challenges that we have in Georgia. Councilman Joe Gibbia, first city in America in Georgia to adopt the Georgia's Not Buying It program. Greg Chevalier is on our board. He's just a tremendous resource to us, and he is essentially a one-man roadshow for Georgia's Not Buying It, and he really gets the word out. Dave McCleary is here. Dave McCleary is a Rotarian, and he takes it very seriously, and for those who don't know, Rotary International set their mind years ago to eradicate polio in the world, and they've been successful. God bless them. And in doing that, they are now looking for the next project. And the next project, as far as David Pierce is concerned, is to expose and eradicate commercial sexual exploitation of children. It's a pretty big deal. Two of my guiding lights in this world are with us. Pastor Paul Palmer from the Atlanta Dream Center. Paul has the Atlanta Dream Center. This is his church. It's right here in downtown in the fourth ward. And Jeff Shaw, who he picked out of a silk stocking law firm here, King and Spalding, if anybody ever heard of that little law firm. Pastor Paul, Jeff is the head of his Out of Darkness program. And between Jeff and Pastor Paul, they have rescued hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of victims off the streets of Atlanta. Paul's been absolutely terrific. Now, you might think I'm in need of a great deal of spiritual guidance, because I am a Christ Paul, and it's probably true. But I also have my dear friend Mike Franklin. Mike, where are you? I can't see you, buddy. Mike drove, there he is. Mike Franklin drove down from Habersham County. He has a mega church up there called The Torch, and they have a great leadership program. And because Clause is about educate, legislate, and litigate, when I told Mike that 2 years ago, Mike said, come on up and educate. Now, it's absolutely a privilege. I want to tell you something about Pastor Paul and walking into the Atlanta Dream Center. My brother David just met him, our executive director. What a fabulous guy he is and a wonderful resource for Clause. But we read and reread and reread, and we tried to figure out, I've been a civil litigator for almost 40 years. How can we use civil laws to restore civility here in the United States? That's what we're working on. And we went down to visit with Pastor Paul, and Pastor Paul was so supportive. And he was so just specific with the problem and how he addresses the problem. And when we left on the sidewalk, David Lester turned around, looked at me, and he said, you know, this has just gone from the abstract to the real. And to everyone in the audience, if you want to really feel what's going on, I would recommend that you get a hold of the Out of Darkness program. Be a Friday night volunteer for Out of Darkness for Pastor Paul and for his church, the Atlanta Dream Center. And actually get in the vans and go to some of the seedier areas of Atlanta and see who's there and see what they're doing and feel it and know that no one made this up. This is a real problem. I don't want to stand up here and give you a lot of statistics and things like that, but I do want to tell you one thing that it happens to me regularly. People say to me, how can human sex trafficking, commercial exploitation of children primarily, how can that be more profitable than illegal drug sales and arms sales? And there's a simple answer. And as you watch our film tonight, you'll be able to see the truth of it. But the simple answer is, how many times can you sell a gram of cocaine? Once. And how many times can you sell a young girl or a young boy? 28, 30 times a night. I mean, it's very sick. Clause started because my daughter came home from India with a t-shirt. And she gave it to me and she said, Daddy, this is a special t-shirt. And I said, yes, of course it is. You brought it from India. And then she said, no, Daddy, it's very special. I said, oh, yes, and the cotton sock. And she said, Daddy, you're not listening. This is a special t-shirt. I go, oh, and well made, too, well made. And she held it up by the two sleeves. And she said, Daddy, you know, the woman that sold me this t-shirt made it with her own hands. And if she sells 3 t-shirts a week, she takes home more money than if she services 20 men a night in the brothel. 3 t-shirts for 20 men a night. I think this is a fabulous venue, and we ought to thank the Atlanta Dream Center for hosting us and allowing us to be here. Now, our dear friends, Pastor Paul and Mike Franklin, they're wonderful, but you know how we actually survive as a charity. We've been adopted by some wonderful businesses in town. One of them adopted us early and has been a staunch supporter. Some of you have enjoyed their hospitality before. But tonight's dinner was given to you by the Capital Grille here in Buckhead. Joy Q adopted us. She's a manager and a marketing guru at Capital Grille. And her manager, Scott Black, is all with her on it. They stand as one. And everything Clause needs, they're there for us. My dear friend Tom Murphy and his lovely wife Susan are sitting in the back, and Tom, all the wines and the spirits of the beers that you're drinking tonight were donated by Tom. Murphy's of Virginia Highlands. You don't need to go far for people to know where that is and how good it is. So I just want you to know who our friends are, and they definitely are friends. I want to also talk to you a little bit about, I mean, Ross Mason's here with Global Philanthropic Leadership. We have, I've told you about Camila and her husband, that's pretty terrific. We have a film that we're going to show you. Are you ready to show it, Dee?
Yeah, you want to introduce.
Look,
you want to introduce the director?
I'm just about to do that, but I was going to tell you that we're going to show it. And the movie was produced, by Joachim. And Joachim, would you come up and just, from South Africa to Texas, the movie from the lot. It's a 90-minute full-feature film, and it's to Hollywood standards. Joachim did it because his life in South Africa, his sister was pulled into the human trafficking, sex slavery business, and he wanted to highlight that. He agrees with us that the first thing we have to do is expose the cancer. And as my partner Bill Stone is here tonight would say, first thing you ever have to do in order to solve a problem is call it by its right name. Joachim has done that.
Guys are pretty radical. I'll take care of formalities real quick. Senator Unterman, it's good to see you again.
Yep.
Attorney General, thank you for the work you're doing. David and David, thank you for the work. Clause, Pastor Paul, no words, right? I mean, just praise God for what he's doing. I'm going to fly fast, guys. It's a real issue. I'm a filmmaker. Each and every one of you have a set of skills and talents. God has bestowed upon you, whether you know that or don't know it, you have a set of skills. Those skills were given to you to better mankind. It's that simple. I'm asking you tonight to watch this film, and at the end of this film, to partner up with Claus. We're here tonight for Claus. It's not about me. I made this film for you. It's your movie. This film was made for you. This film was made for Pastor Paul, for Sam Ackerman, for Miss Wright, and for David, so that we can take this thing and bring awareness to a crime that's real. My family was impacted. My sister was trafficked for 6 years. My sister was a recording artist at the top of her game in an industry, and a CEO saw a better fit, could make more money by selling her for sex than selling records. So once you understand, this is real. We're talking about stuff that's real here. So at the end of the night tonight, you're gonna have an opportunity to partner up with Claus. And I'm asking you to do that. The film's going to move you. It's radical and it's real. We partnered with Homeland Security, the United Nations last week, and I have to say this, Attorney General, if you're here, Georgia has had a black eye for many years in this issue. I promise you, I traveled the world. 2 weeks from now, 3 weeks from now, I'm in the Dominican Republic at the U.S. Embassy running an initiative with Ambassador Brewster. From around the world, Georgia is now leading the race and fixing the problem. Thanks to you. There's absolutely no doubt that I talk more about Georgia when they ask me, how do we fix the problem? Last week I addressed the National Hispanic Bar Association in Florida. And they said, how do we fix it? I said, you gotta look at Georgia. Georgia, who we used to think was the place, Georgia's fixing it. So I want to commend you. Nobody does more at a judicial level than Senator Unterman. Nobody. Last thing I'll say is when we make the film, I want to thank my team. I'm one guy of a small army. We're a film production company. Every film we'll ever do will address a social issue. We will never get off this issue because it's personal, ever. We will drive this thing until we eradicate a crime. Sweden did it. They did it. You know what Sweden said?
Don't buy
yes. We have to rescue, yes, we have to rehabilitate, and yes, we have to foster. And that two-year program is going to be amazing. But we have to. And I wish we could give this a different name. We have to go after the John. Yeah. And I'm sorry if your name is John.
We call him the customer.
But the customer. But we got to cut the demand.
And if you don't know, the average customer in Atlanta, which is the highest profit area in the United States, comes from just outside the Beltway. He makes probably about $41,000 a year on the average, and he comes into the city to do his nasty. We can use civil laws to restore civility. We can help law enforcement. We can become aware of this problem. We can thank Joaquin for really exposing the problem, and that begins the cure.
You guys, please, this is not a film where you go home and you go, yay, yeah, this is not Avengers. This is a film that's going to challenge humanity, and it's going to challenge your core belief system. And praise God, and I say that, thank my team, my wife, praise God that you have an opportunity to do something about it. You have Atlanta Dream Center, and you have Claws, because you will tonight at the end of this night. Because honestly, God produced this film. No, I didn't produce this film. But yeah, absolutely. You will at the end of the night have a feeling in your stomach saying this can't go on.
Yeah.
And there's two entities here that you can team up with and take some of those skills God gave you. I don't, if you're in medical services, then you can say, Pastor Paul, we would like to come talk to the girls. If you're a teacher and you teach languages, yes, the girls need it. So just thank you. Thank you very much.
Okay. Thank you.
Appreciate
it. If you're a lawyer, we can use your taps. You know, Brittany Conklin just came up a second ago, and Brittany, you might have already been tapped on your shoulder, but I'll tell you, Brittany is our staff attorney. We're all volunteers. Brittany is working her tail off on this thing, and I'll tell you, if she hadn't tapped you, she might, or you might email us at Claws, www.usclaws.org. Brittany is pulling together the first Claws Brain Trust Enclave of lawyers to help us pull together options where we can assist in filing lawsuits and taking the dollars out of the game so that this business contracts instead of grows. And your film is based on a true story of abduction out of Texas. And it's an upper middle class family. I want you to watch it. It's really, I've watched it now twice in preview for you. And I'll tell you, there are great lessons to it.
Thank you. You want to share it with me?
Well, we hope that you appreciate the movie. It's a real problem, and we can pull together and make a difference. This is the biggest social cancer that exists in our time. And almost all of us that sit in this room today know that the courthouse has two sides. It has a criminal side and it has a civil side. And during our lifetime, during my 61 years of life as of my birthday yesterday, the greatest part of civil change, women's rights, voting rights, civil rights, safer workplaces, safer drugs, have come from using the civil side of the courthouse. And as civil lawyers, what we would like to do is put our brains together and make a difference and help our dear law enforcement folks. Sam Olens is truly a friend of the citizens of Georgia. He wants to put an end to human trafficking and sex slavery. Gala Wright is truly a friend of the citizens of Georgia, and she's dedicated her life to this. And as civil lawyers, we want to band together and to help. And we need your help. We have in Georgia and in Atlanta, we have an absolute wonderful gift. Kara Claudy is an Atlanta-based singer-songwriter whose lyrics are informed by the multicultural identity and international upbringing that she's had. The daughter of a United States Marine and a Korean mother, Kara spent her childhood in points as exotic as Okinawa, Japan, and is All-American as Aurora, Colorado, in northeastern Indiana. My daughter went to India, remember? I had it on my own. Her debut debut album released in May of this year, the dynamic tempos coupled with her powerful voice recall crossover artists like Lisa Love, Sarah McLachlan, and even a touch of David Gray. She's been featured on CBS 46, Second Atlanta Unplugged. She's been in North Point's Magazine, in the Live Lounge for 97.1 The River. She's become a fixture at several Atlanta venues and festivals. Kara is honored to perform a song that she has composed for Claus as a message of hope. And in a rallying cry for those impacted by and joined together in the fight against world sex slavery, Kara named this song, Now That We Know, in honor of our tonight.
And I want you to know, I have not seen this film before.
You've never seen the film before? This is a debut. It's the first time that Kara has ever performed this song in public. And my brother has arranged that we're going to see the lyrics up here. Now, what I'd like for you to do is please give, Kara's worked hard on this, please sit still, be calm, enjoy this. When Kara's finished, I'm going to have a short message for you, and then my brother and I are going to ask that you retire back to the same room where we had dinner for a little dessert.
One moment. In your seats, you found two cards. One is a donation card, and one is a volunteer card. We'd love for you to take just a few moments and fill those out. We have some volunteers with baskets. They're going to pass them through. And if you would kindly put those in the basket so that we can take your donations and your volunteer cards. And okay, if you just give them a moment to do that, and then it's all yours.
While you're writing into on your donor card, and we appreciate that, we also want to remind you that Claus is governed by a board of directors. The board of directors is featured on our website. We have businessmen and women. We have law enforcement. We have lawyers. We have an accountant that specializes in charitable corporations. We thank each and every one of them. We need your talent, we need your time, and we need your economic support. Okay, and one thing that my Karen wanted to remind me, we have some lovely silent auction donations. My friend Dan Davis, who is the wine guy at Commander's Palace in New Orleans, came up here for tonight's event. And he has given us, for the silent auction, a dinner with paired wines. Our friend David Biscoe with Hilton Corporation has imposed upon the Waldorf Astoria in New Orleans to do a wraparound staycation. That's one of our silent auction items. It's been donated for the benefit of Claus. We have a number of other great values that are up there. I took a look at the list, and I think that there's plenty of room for you to get a lot of bang for your buck, so to speak, with the silent auction. Mike Aaron has arranged it so that when Kara is finished, you're going to have about 15 minutes more to enjoy the silent auction as we go into the desserts. We'd love to keep talking about the subject. We'd love to keep moving forward with the subject. And Kara, would you please sing the song that you wrote for Claus called Now That We Know?
Love a word.
thing is that social scientists that are working on this project at UCF and elsewhere will tell you it is much easier to raise healthy children than to fix broken adults. If we put our energy into this project, we can solve the problem. We can help law enforcement, we can give them the resources that they need, and we can move forward. Let's apply science to this terribly social human problem, this epidemic in our society. And if you don't think it's epidemic, I want to tell you one thing. Do you know what these handlers, what these boyfriends, what these managers call our schools and our shopping malls? The buffet. Is it, this is a predatory game. With social science, we can understand the weaknesses that are preyed upon, and we can figure out the solutions. Employing the civil side of the courthouse and the resources of civil lawyers, we can bring about social change. We can take the money out of the game. We can take the $10 billion out of the project in the United States annually. We can work on it. So let's work together. I'd like for you all to retire. Please finish up with the silent auction. Go back in the room. Let's have some dessert. Let's talk.
Establishment for sex. that's a business that once we do the criminal part, having the civil side shut them down is a really good thing.
Okay, so do we have the eyes and ears on the hospitality industry?
We've already trained many hoteliers, taxi drivers, Central Atlanta Progress ambassadors. Whenever we have an event in Georgia, like the Final Four, the Super Bowl, etc., we are under the radar training, working with our partners, the GBI State Patrol, FBI Task Force. We don't do it in front of the press. We do it privately. Right. Right. Multi-day training in Savannah. Savannah hasn't had a training yet.
Oh,
so it's not only Atlanta, we're going throughout the state. Right. Well, every year with the Masters, you have a similar task force to assist them.
Thank you very much for being here.
My pleasure. Thank you for being here. Thank you. You know, APD, DeKalb, there are numerous police departments that are really doing an excellent job here. The more we train, the better we can have that assistance throughout the state.
We have some powerhouses here in the room, and I hope Nydia will capture the room here, but we have law enforcement, we have the rotary, we have legislators, right. We have businessmen. I mean, the stay-at-home moms, I mean, everybody that makes up our society needs to keep an eye on this and cooperate and expect the best of everyone around us, and that's how we're going to deal with this problem. But putting money into the organizations that are holding people accountable, because we know, unfortunately, law enforcement can't handle the entire world.
Uh-huh. Right.
So we want you to handle everything you can, but we're going to, whether it's flanking the sides, bringing up the rear, you know, however we get there, we're going to make sure that we find ways
everyone
to help.
Everyone can help.
Thank you.
My pleasure. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you.
Just a friendly reminder to sign an option.